Well, some of the best recipes are family recipes that are handed down through the generations. And the dessert we're making doesn't require a lot of fuss, just a few quality ingredients and a little bit of love. Probably the most important ingredient there. Louis Green is the owner of Elizabeth Richard Gibson Waterbury and is here to share a family favorite. This has been smelling delicious all afternoon, Lori. Terrific. It's a coffee cake, it looks like, right?
It is. It's a coffee cake. It's a great recipe. It was handed down from my grandmother. And when I was trying to decide what to make for our annual Mother's Day brunch at the shop, mm-hmm. I came up with this because I remembered my grandfather used to work at Scoville's, as did many, many inhabitants of Waterbury at the time. And he worked the 3-to-3 shift,
wow.
3 a.m. to 3 p.m. And he would come home and he would be dead tired. He'd want a cup of coffee, a little snack, and then he'd want to go take a nap. So my grandmother always had a coffee cake ready for him. And this
great.
Was his favorite cake. And he preferred to have it with a nice cup of black coffee and a little dollop of homemade whipped cream
on the
side.
And that's what we have right there.
And that's what we've got. So I'm honoring my grandmother this Mother's Day
sure.
with her recipe.
I love it. Well, I can't wait to learn how to make it. But first, Lori, tell me a little bit about the shop. It's right on the Waterbury Middlebury line off exit 17. And you have just about everything in there.
We do. We have just about everything. We're doing bridal registries, which is really popular at this time of year. It's really great. We've got some collectibles. We've got baby goods, all kinds of stuff. And it's a treat for the eyes when you come in.
Yeah, if you need a Mother's Day gift, it's a perfect spot.
We are the place to go for a Mother's Day gift and so much more.
And chances are you'll leave with something for yourself, because
yes.
I usually do every time I'm in there. But all right, Lori, tell me how we get started here.
All right, this is a really easy recipe.
Okay.
You know, as you know, Teresa, I am not a fan of the recipe that has like a million ingredients and,
right.
you know, things I don't have at home. So this is right up my alley, as are most vintage recipes I'm finding.
Hmm.
So we're going to start out with 2 cups of sugar. I've already put it into the mixing bowl, and we've got 2 sticks of softened butter.
Okay.
Now the big debate is, do you use salted butter or unsalted butter? In this particular recipe, I'm using salted butter because, whoops.
All right, well, there you go. Now we're in business.
Now we're cooking there. We're using salted butter on this one.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I think Channel 8 set might need a new mixer.
Huh?
I think I know where to get one.
You do have those of Elizabeth Richards, don't you?
We're going to use salted butter with this recipe because there is no salt added to this particular recipe.
Okay.
So if this were mixing up, which it's going, there we go. It's going crazy.
A little mind of its own, though.
So
all right.
We're going to add 4 eggs.
Okay.
We've got 4 large eggs. We're going to try to slow this guy down. Although it's not working. So we're going to pretend over here.
All right,
we're
putting the eggs
improvise.
In there.
It's a good thing I made that one last night because this wasn't going to work today. We're going to put 4 eggs in here. We're going to mix that up really, really well.
Okay.
And then we're going to add about a teaspoon or so of vanilla. I like to use the Nielsen Massey vanilla. It's a really good quality. It's so much better than the vanilla that you buy at the grocery store.
Really?
The vanilla that you buy at the grocery store is just imitation extract. It just has the flavoring. It's not really from the beans. So go on out, splurge, get yourself a nice bottle of vanilla.
Got it.
From there, we're going to add in a tablespoon of baking powder and a tablespoon of baking soda. Then we are going to alternate 4 cups of flour and a pint and a little extra of sour cream. And I'll tell you, one of the things that when I was testing out this recipe before I brought it down here, if I used just a pint of sour cream, mm-hmm. it tended to be a little on the crumbly side.
Oh.
So I did go ahead and I took the liberty of adding about another 1/2 cup to my grandmother's recipe. So that's that. Once that's all blended up,
mm-hmm.
we're gonna put it into a pan. Now, Teresa, you gotta be real careful. The first time I made this,
yes.
I was not quite so careful. This is an Angel food pan. And it's an Angel food pan. It comes out like this. So everything that's on the top is going to always stay on the top.
Sure.
So we're going to put about 1/2 of our batter in. We're going to top it with about 2/3 of our topping.
So you put the topping right in before you bake
right
it?
Right in.
Okay.
Yep. Then we're going to finish adding the batter to the top of it. And then we're just going to add the remaining part of our center filling. And we're going to pat it down with our spatula a little bit just
Got
to kind of sink it in there. Now, if you don't have an Angel food pan at home and you do have a Bundt pan, what you're going to want to remember.
This.
Yeah, it's one of those nice little silicone bakers,
yeah.
and it really does work well. What you're going to want to remember is you're going to want to reverse the recipe, Teresa. You're going to want to put your topping in first. Then you're going to want to put your batter, then you're going to put your filling, then you're going to top it off with more batter. And depending on the size of your Bundt pan, you may or may not have some batter left over. If you do have some batter left over, throw it in some muffin pans or throw it in a little mini loaf pan and just have like a little extra something for
yourself.
Sounds
great. Great.
And then this is going to bake in the oven at 375 for 1 hour.
Great.
But you're going to check it at about 50 minutes or so because you don't want to overcook it.
And it's going to turn out just like that.
It is. It's going to turn out just like that. And I also brought along the newest little gadget at the store that I'm absolutely positively in love with. It's the Nespresso Virtuo coffee maker, and maybe you've seen the commercials with Penelope Cruz. This is an absolute fantastic machine. It not only does espresso, which Nespresso is known for, but it's also making regular cups of coffee.
That's great, so you don't have to have two machines on your countertop.
No, I no longer have two machines, and it's a simple little load, lock, press the button, and boom, you're all done. You're ready to go.
I love that.
So, and you can find that at the store, and if you come up this weekend on Saturday from 10 to 2, I'll have all kinds of Mother's Day treats out. We have some goodie bags. We've got a cookbook to give out that the staff has helped me compile.
Sounds like a party.
I'll be making some coffee for everybody.
All right, fantastic. And again, that's happening on Saturday. What time do we need to get there?
Saturday from 10 to 2. The store itself is open from 10 to 4, but 10 to 2 for all the goodies.
For the party.
Yep.
All right, and if you'd like to check out Elizabeth Richard Gifts, you can log on to their website, elizabethrichardgifts.com, or visit them over at their store, which is located on the Middlebury-Waterbury line off exit 17. You can also find them on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Lori, thanks so much for being here. I can't wait to dig in.